Good evening.
Good evening.
All right, so we're going to talk about the 2024 pocket guide, which we have bought from the members, yes. And it costs $7. I'm not sure if non-members can access this pocket guide, but this has been really useful in for us managing and organizing what we wanted to see at the show.
Especially after sitting down in the pavilion, having a red and a great northern and just watching the dog-eared pages.
Look, I do recommend if you want to go to the show several times that you become a member, because it is worth it, because you do have access to the show every single day. Mm. And it does work out cheaper in the long run, because, there are so many things to see and do. So this is a daily guide, and it's jam-packed full of information that we didn't realize we had been missing. Tell me about the bookmark.
Well, the bookmark is a dog.
What type of dog?
A flat one. Sorry. It is a kelpie.
So where did you get it?
I didn't. You did.
Where did we go to get it, you silly goose?
It was from the land is a magazine newspaper in this country, and it's a bookmark from the land.
Yeah, so we got the voucher from the RAS Foundation, Give and Gather. You see, I'm just plugging the RAS's Give and Gather show back. Just because it is worth your while if you want to save money on your visit to the show. That show bag is pretty brilliant. Mm. So they had these stacks of bookmarks, and because Mr. Martin doesn't agree with me dog earing the pocket guide.
The irony in this whole thing is your bookmark is a dog.
Indeed, it is. That's why I think the land had had this pile of bookmarks to give away to people with their vouchers. Mm. Now, do you want to open the pocket guide for today's guide? Now, not for today's.
Going through, we have the map.
We have the map.
Indexing.
So, how big is it? Just put your hand against it.
It's a pocket guide.
So you can definitely. I think
you could put it in a pair of shorts.
Yeah, or jeans.
Yeah.
No, that we can't wear shorts to the member stand. There is a dress code to the member stand, so if you decide to become a member, please observe the member stand or you won't be able to get in.
Yeah. So, yeah, but it's a pocket guide. I mean, it'll get in your back pocket, your jeans or cargo pants.
Yeah. Okay, go on.
But this is what a typical day in the life of...
Oh, but that's the 1st of April. That's April Fool's Day. Why don't you go to where my bookmark is? Then you can see the day. Oops, I still dog-eared that.
Dog-eared.
Okay, so the first half of the book, the pocket guide, is actually about the main arena, what's happening at the main arena. So the second half is actually, see, look, rural bookshop. Yeah, it was the land's bookshop was there, and you were looking at several books there. because Mr. Martin's a bit of a prepper.
And to any librarians out there, please do not comment on the bottom of this about dog ears in books. I have already told.
anyway, let's move on. Do you want to go to the first half? Because I think we've moved on. Oh, I don't know which bit that is. Okay, but yeah. So I'll see, there's another dog here there. Look, I wish they gave us two bookmarks instead of just one.
You can have 500 bookmarks and still end up dog ears.
All right. Well, look, today we watched the young riders compete in the show jumping. Mm-hmm. But it was running late. So here, I said the schedule was at 2:50, but I think the time we arrived at the main arena was around 4 o'clock.
Yeah, so they
were running late. But look, as you can see, this is what they have because the main arena is divided into four rings. And for those of you who spend a lot of time at the main arena, you will see what they have there as well. But if you look towards here, you will see what the nighttime entertainment is, including the bison stampede. So tonight I went up to the upper stand of the member stand, but I think I'll have to view it in different ways. I mean, I suppose that's the pleasure of being able to go to the show every single day. There's always something different.
Mm. And you can look at something from a different angle.
Yeah, it's a live performance, so to speak. All right, go on, keep on going.
Yeah, that's about it, really. I mean, you just flick through and...
Did we miss the first few pages? Was there anything in the first few pages there?
Not really.
Oh, there's some members...
Your notes and a bit of basic information, but...
Yeah, so they've got the different pavilions daily, the Heritage Pavilion, which is a bit unloved because it's not really in a good spot. So that's the one that closes early with a farmyard nursery. So tomorrow, Monday, is the next Grand Parade. And the last one is on Saturday. So, yes, that Grand Parade was a bit of a shocker, I thought. It was, I think there were a couple of nervous cattle handlers there.
It went to the bulls.
Yeah, so my sympathies to all the cattle handlers on the opening of that Grand Parade.
They do a cracking job considering what the average bull's 500 kilos.
Yeah, so, at least nobody got injured.
Well, most of those handlers would be lucky to be 80 kilos.
Yeah, so and some of the young ones too.
Mm.
Anything else on the other pages? Yeah, so, okay. So it actually shows... the different bars and restaurants there.
And where to go if you lose your persons?
Yes.
I've tried losing the certain persons, but she keeps finding me.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, but I think the lost persons there, I'm not sure how popular it is.
The lost persons?
Yeah.
Depends if you want to get found or not.
Oh, dear. Yeah, go on.
And then you've got mobile phone charging locations and things like that.
Yeah. So... Yeah, I think that's becoming of a concern, you know. Battery life doesn't last long, like my one. Okay.
Mm.
Anything else on the other page? Yeah, so that's...
Oh, what to do if there's an evacuation and a fire? Race.
Mm-hmm.
Out of there.
Okay.
And then you just basically go into the how they break their thing down.
Yeah, so for the ring, really, they start early, so at 8 o'clock in the morning. And, so it's a full 12
That's why Miss Martin hours. Never actually sees the first event.
Well, we're not allowed to go in until, I think, 9:30, if you go back and see what time the show starts. Yeah. So the general public, I don't think you can go in that early. Unless, of course, you're exhibiting. Okay. All right.
And that's about it. Then you're just basically going into the rings.
Yeah, so as you can see, there's so many classes, and especially...
Your wood chopping's thrown in there, your dog events, everything's thrown in there.
Yeah, I think that's in the other section, isn't it? Because you've got the Schmidt Arena as well, which is the other horse ring, and then you've got the other...
Mm. This is just randomly throwing.
Yeah, so this is the main arena because it's got different rings, so if you want to keep on turning the page. So, look, there is a lot. So this is more, yeah, this is the overall one.
Is there anything on blank pages?
Anything on the back page?
No, just a purple bit.
No. The last few pages.
Nah, just the last ring events.
Well, what is the last event when you think about it? Oh, okay. They've got a couple of music artists at the members bar. Okay.
Okay.
So that members bar will be on full blast.
Rocking for a bit.
Yeah. All right, Mr. Martin needs to go to sleep, so we'd better close this because, you know, he's got an early start.
2024.
Yeah, 2024. So they've got goats. Oh, no, that reminds me of my goats. But anyway, all right, so onwards and upwards. So tomorrow is the fourth day. I'll see if I can go because tomorrow is another Grand Parade. So we shall see. Okay, bye for now.
Oh, yeah.